All right, welcome back, people, to No Decorum. I'm AJ.
And I'm Daniel.
And today, we're going to talk about Mr. Shapiro.
Benjamin Shapiro?
Yes.
All right, let's talk about him. Okay, so he's made some news recently about his stance on transgender, right?
Yeah, he's a little obsessed with it.
He seems to be obsessed.
Yeah, I don't know why.
And it's a pretty unhealthy way, it seems to be. You know, just it's almost too focused. But either way, he was commenting on the recent Sports Illustrated cover with, I think he had the name of the trans.
Yes, Leanna Bloom?
Leanna Bloom.
Yeah.
So it's a transgender female?
Yes.
On the cover of Sports Illustrated. And
time when Sports Illustrated was supposed to be a sports magazine. Yeah, that was funny. Sports Illustrated, I was a long time subscriber to Sports Illustrated. I will acknowledge that as a religious person, I always took the option, you can do this, of calling up Sports Illustrated and not getting the swimsuit edition, which was, you know, basically material for teenage boys. I would always call up Sports Illustrated and say, add an issue to the end of my subscription and just don't send the swimsuit edition. But the swimsuit edition has been a long time thing for Sports Illustrated, and always basically it was hot models and body paint on the beach. That's always what it was. Well, now Sports Illustrated, because it has become another preserve of the woke, has decided that it is time to cram down on red-blooded American males a particular perception of female beauty, namely dudes. So there is a trans woman who has now been featured on the cover of Sports Illustrated. This is the trans woman whose name is Leanna Bloom. Now, Leanna Bloom has had surgeries and hormone treatment and looks physically like a woman. Right, which, by the way, seems rather transphobic to me. Because if you truly, Sports Illustrated, wanted to make the case that trans women are women, then trans women shouldn't have to look like swimsuit models. In fact, trans women, I mean, this seems fatphobic to me. Trans women should actually look like Laurel Hubbard. Why isn't Laurel Hubbard on the cover of the Sports Illustrated swimsuit edition? You know, the New Zealand weightlifter who's now going to be weightlifting in the Olympics and has more to do with sports than Leanna Bloom. And why is it that only a trans woman who looks like a stereotypical swimsuit model in a low-cut bikini is now considered a fitting figure for the cover of Sports Illustrated? It seems very, very fatphobic, very transphobic, frankly, because it seems to suggest that the only trans women who ought to be treated as women are trans women who conform to all stereotypes regarding women. I mean, Leanna Bloom, my understanding is, has had all of the surgeries to fake female body parts. But as we know, that is to suggest that is a requirement of trans women to be treated as women is violative of their norms. It is violative of decency. So truly, Sports Illustrated has not gone far enough until Sports Illustrated suggests that red-blooded American males get used to the idea of a trans woman who looks exactly like a man. Because as we know, sex is really all in your head. Gender is really all in your head.
Of course, Ben Shapiro is triggered because we've all heard of his stance on it.
Yeah, because she was asking him out on a date.
I think he got excited.
Yeah.
He got a little excited, and when he realized it was a trans woman, he became disgusted.
Yeah.
He was tricked.
I bet if he would have saw her, he would see her walking down the street, he would not be able to tell if this is a guy or a girl.
I can honestly say I couldn't tell.
Yeah.
So, and I'm a pretty good judge.
Yeah.
Either way.
And I'm sure he has not seen more than one.
Yeah.
Women naked in his life anyway.
If even one.
Yeah.
I mean, who knows? It may have been one of those other kind of pregnancies, but.
We're just speculating. We don't know.
Yeah.
Ben Shapiro's sex life.
This isn't fact-based.
We have no idea. Yeah.
I mean, he doesn't either, probably.
We don't like to be in people's bedroom. They do.
They do.
That's their thing.
And their gender as well.
Yeah. They want to tell other people who to have sex with.
Yeah. And who to identify
to love,
as.
Yeah. What they want to do with their lives. All those things. When to have babies, when not to have babies.
It only, I mean, they unless it's, you know, if you're an anti-vaxxer, then it's your body, your choice. But
yeah.
If you're gay or trans, it's no. You won't have an abortion.
If you want to become a mother or not, no.
No.
You are doing these things.
You're going against God's will. And I suspect
but
it's, you know.
You want to be a transgender? No, you can't do that.
No.
That's at that time, it's not your body anymore.
Interesting.
For some reason.
Go figure. Maybe secretly, I don't know. I don't want
to
speculate.
I don't want to speculate, but maybe he wants to be a transgender woman? Could be.
I mean, Ben, go for it. You know, you got to follow your heart, man.
Yeah.
Follow your instincts.
You should do it. I mean, you are so obsessed. You are more obsessed with transgender than transgender people themselves.
You need to channel your inner uterus, James. Ben, sorry. And just become who you're meant to be.
Yeah.
Right? So, yeah, so this has this weird fixation on trans people. Obviously the right has always had a fixation on sex in general. Social issues. Because we know one thing. Their policies are nonsense.
Yeah.
And they're very unpopular. And so they tried to win the culture war, right?
Yes.
Well, they've been losing the culture war for quite a long time now. Because they're stuck in the 1800s. And they don't want to adapt. They don't want to modernize. And this is the next incarnation of that. It's a trans. It was gays, right?
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure it was interracial first. And then it was gays.
Yeah, interracial was the first one.
Yeah. Yeah. And now it's the trans community. So
yeah, it was gays, and then it was gay marriage.
Oh yes, oh yes, because it was gonna have a negative effect on traditional family values. Really?
Yeah.
Did it?
Even in one of the most progressive president, Obama, was evolved on that.
He evolved on the issue
after he got elected.
Well,
second time.
It was then safe to do it. Okay.
Yeah. Before that, until 2012, he did not believe in it. And November 2012, all of a sudden, it changed.
I'm all on. I'm on board.
Yeah.
Didn't Clinton also evolve on it as well?
Yeah, he did.
What the other Clinton?
The lady?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, everyone evolves on it, don't they?
Yeah, they all, before it was don't. Say or don't tell.
Don't ask, don't tell.
Yeah, don't ask, don't tell. Now is all tell.
Yeah, I don't know what the evolution part is, but okay. It sounds like political speak. But anyways, yeah. Back to Ben Shapiro. We have to focus on Ben Shapiro.
All right.
This is all about him.
So he had a debate, but he was ranting on his channel today.
Oh, that's good.
And also, he had a little conversation with a little scientist known as Neil deGrasse Tyson. Well, he's not little. He's a very big man.
I've heard he's a big man. Yeah. I've heard the name. Maybe a science educator, astrophysicist.
Yeah, he's a doctor.
I think he did Cosmos.
Yeah.
Did you watch that documentary or that little series?
Yes, I did.
It was good.
Yeah.
Oh, nice production value. Yeah. Yes, Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson. I think he got his PhD at UT.
Yes.
University of Texas. All right. Anyway, so they were talking about the transgender community, and he brought the fact that the only reason people care about it is because of sports, right?
Yeah.
Sports. And because we have segregate by gender and things of that nature. But in the broader scheme in society,
yeah,
nobody really cares. It doesn't affect anybody. I mean, no one's losing a job or, you know, making less money because there's transgender people out there. Mm-hmm. It's just a cultural issue.
Although he did provide a solution.
Let's do it. What is it?
He said we can, instead of segregating sports based on sex, we can segregate on hormone levels.
Hormone level, that'll work?
Yeah.
Let's do that. Measure the level of testosterone or estrogen in your body and put you in that group and be good to go.
Yeah.
Why not?
See who's more aggressive.
I like
it. Put that lady with the most aggressive man.
Any objections? All right, problem solved.
Yeah.
But we all know that's not the real issue.
Yeah, that is not a solution. I mean, we're all just joking here.
The real issue here.
I don't know if Neil deGrasse Tyson was joking, but
who knows?
Yeah.
I think it's one of disgust. And I've always thought this. When I hear conservatives talk about these things or evangelicals or they want to use the Bible to, you know, support their beliefs, but really it's just disgust.
Yeah.
The idea of gay people discuss them, of trans people discuss them, and they couch it in religious terms, but in fact, it's just a guttural reaction to the idea of two same-sex people loving each other or transgender people existing in the world. They want to have a more intellectualized conversation about what is ultimately a very primal reaction to an idea.
Yeah.
It can't be done.
I mean, because they really don't want to solve real problems.
They can't.
These are not problems. And they're very easy to talk about.
Yep.
And make an issue. And
rile people up.
Yeah, where they really don't have to do anything.
No. No, you just complain.
Yeah.
Where the real issues, as we've talked about before, like climate change,
healthcare,
poverty, healthcare, homeless. I mean, there's so many other issues that actually matter.
Actually matters to people. And it matters to everybody because healthcare, everybody gets sick. Conservative or liberal. It doesn't matter.
You have to live somewhere.
Yeah, cancer does not care if you're conservative.
That's right. Doesn't care. Maybe you should. No.
Yeah. I mean, climate change affects conservatives the same way as the liberals.
I think because they know. Yeah, I think I know the problem is here. Yeah. So especially in America, the liberals are on the coast.
Yeah.
And so when the waters rise and eat the cities up, they're not going to care. Like, well, it's just liberals
I mean, I think that's their whole plan is they want to drown them.
They want to drown it out. I will say, I guess, like Louisiana and some of those will be affected as well. But
in that same interview, actually, Neil deGrasse Tyson did bring up climate change also.
He did. And he made a very salient point about it.
Yeah.
Not the exaggerated claims of like hundreds of feet of seawater rise.
No.
He said no. How much was it?
It was 1 inch.
1 inch of seawater. A rise of 1 inch can cause devastating effects on coastal cities. That's all it takes. Just 1 inch.
1 inch.
And we know that Greenland is melting and Antarctica is melting. This is not outside the realm of possibility.
Nope.
Not to mention the islands in the South Pacific, as we said.
Yeah, they will be underwater pretty much.
Yeah, it's happening.
Yeah.
It's happening, whether you choose to admit it or not.
We got a preview. Sandy.
Yeah, Hurricane Sandy was pretty bad.
Yeah, and Katrina was also a preview. Flooding didn't happen because of hurricane, but the effects of it, you could see what happened.
Yeah.
If the levees break or whatever your remedy is going to be to protect the coastal cities, you can build walls. But if sea rises 1 inch, if big hurricane comes in, it's bringing a lot of water.
Yeah.
It's not just 1 inch water coming in.
And he said near infinite amounts of water.
Yeah.
I mean, there you go. That's you're not going to hold back an entire ocean.
No. Nope.
But I think it was a good conversation. I thought whenever you spell it out that way and you don't make it in those exaggerated terms, people see it much more clearly.
Yeah.
Whether they accept it or not is another story. But what was the word Ben Shapiro used about that? People just... blowing out of proportion.
Yeah.
It was hit a word for him.
I can't remember right now. I'll look it up.
Yeah, we'll look it up for you. We'll put it in the notes or something. But we need more conversations like that.
We need people like him to come on to
our
conservative
shows,
our show for sure. Yeah. But they need to come on people like Tucker Carlson, Sean Hannity, and school them in this area. You know, spell it out for them.
Yeah.
Basically, if you looked at it, Ben Shapiro was basically a bobblehead doll.
Just, I mean, very little response to what he's saying because, one of them is a scientist and one of them is a talking head. So it's different. It's a different level of intellect and understanding. But, and also you have honesty on one side, intellectual honesty. On the other side, you have, outrage.
Yeah, I mean, Ben Shapiro, by profession, he's a lawyer.
Yeah.
He can argue. He can come up with argumentative points, but he's not really intellect.
And he's not looking for truth either.
Yeah.
He's looking to score points.
Yeah, I mean, he's just looking to make you look bad. That's about it.
Yeah. And reinforce his own ideas and
impress
his audience and get more subscribers, and which is fine.
He's chasing money. Which is...
businessman.
Yeah, I mean, I don't have any problem with that. People want to follow him, listen to him. It's okay. As long as it doesn't affect anybody else's life. Their policies don't come in to become laws.
Well, we know that that often does happen. But anyways.
Yeah.
But Yeah, I thought it was important to bring that up. And
he was also triggered by Naomi Osaka's cover.
Oh, yeah.
And also a rapper on Sports Illustrated is on there, too.
Oh, Megan Thee Stallion.
Yeah, I don't know if these women were just minority women, a little bit dark. That triggered him.
Possibly. Very possibly. Or that they're successful, or I don't know. I'm not sure what is.
I mean, why would you criticize Naomi for being on the cover of a magazine? I have no idea. He said that she has anxiety issues, but she has no problem being on the cover. Well, she also plays in front of lots of fans, so she doesn't have that problem. She just doesn't want to talk to reporters.
That should be, you know, this is not a black and white issue. I mean, anxiety has many levels, many degrees.
Yeah.
It manifests in different ways. He should know that. He said he had family members who have anxiety. So, again, being dishonest, again. But, you know, that's fine. And as far as Megan Thee Stallion, what in the world? I mean, these people are all, like, self-made people.
Yeah.
You know, they're their own talent, their own skill. They made, you know, a life for themselves. What is his problem with that?
I mean, they should be proud of that, right? This is what they're always talking about. Pull yourself up. Well, and this is what they did.
They certain people.
Oh, okay.
Certain. Yeah, so was it Megan Thee Stallion who said she wanted to be on the cover of Sports Illustrated?
Ever since she was a little girl.
And he said that was a weird dream or something? Yeah. Like, who would say what a weird dream is?
I mean, what is it? I mean, our weird dream is you wearing that stupid thing on your head.
And you believing it has some weird significance. Yeah.
I mean, what is that cloth does? What is it? What are you trying to protect?
I don't know.
Is there a bald spot there? What is it?
We need to find out. Inquiring minds want to know.
Yeah.
We'll pay somebody $10 to find out what's under that thing on his head. But
why all religious people have to wear hats anyway? Why every religion has some sort of a dumb hat?
I asked the Pope. I don't really know.
I mean, what is the hat does? I mean, does that give you powers? I mean, God doesn't like to see naked head. I mean, what is it?
Well, God is conservative, AJ.
Doesn't want to see hair?
He doesn't want to see hair.
He could have made everybody bald, just like the babies.
Well,
or Donald perfect. Trump. He's
he left it to us, AJ. He couldn't give us everything, right? Maybe perfection is a bald head, but he couldn't give us everything. Right. So it's up to us to make his dream a reality.
And to come up with a funny looking hat.
And funny sounding words
that
you say over funny sounding pieces of whatever cookies and they became flesh and or whatever happens, I don't know. Or, you know, speaking in tongues.
Or bottled water becomes holy water or something.
Take your pick.
Yeah. It coming from some company anyway.
Yeah, know. For sure.
Yeah.
But, yeah, anyways, I thought it was an interesting issue.
He's...
his fixation is unhealthy, first of all. But
we're just wondering. We want to know if people have any sort of knowledge. Please comment down below.
Yeah.
Let us know that he's not trying to become... Or is researching to become transgender himself.
Maybe he's trying to argue himself out of becoming transgender.
E.T. Transgender E.T.
But whatever choice he makes, we wish him the best. And if he decides to go down that path, we'll support him 100%.
Yeah. We'll be right there to push you out of space.
Out of Jeff Bezos' dick rocket. But whatever the case is. Anything else, AJ?
No, I think that's enough rant on Benihana. Ben Shapiro.
All right. Well, thanks for joining us. Another episode of No Decorum.
Please like and subscribe. That tells us that you like our material.
And it
helps us.
It helps our self-worth.
Yeah.
It helps us feel better about being us. So anyway, thanks again, and we'll see you next time.